Hello everyone and welcome back. This is Doc Ed Padama. I created another template guide, this time in writing chapter 5, the summary of findings, conclusion, and recommendations. So this will be very helpful to students and research writers who are already in this part of their study. So before we proceed, again, let me remind everyone who are listening to this, listening and watching to this particular video discussion, that we will be using Tagalog and English throughout the discussion of this particular topic. So if you are not yet familiar with how you should compose and how you should write your chapter 5, the summary of findings, conclusions, and recommendations, this will be the perfect guide for you. Again, if you want to use this template as part of your report in your class, or you would like this video to be a supplemental material in helping your discussion in writing chapter 5, please do take note of what is written at the bottom in the fine print. No part of this material may be reproduced, stored in a retrieval system, or transmitted in any form or by any means, electronic, mechanical, photocopying, recording, or otherwise without a prior written consent from the owner. So this means that if you would like to use this particular template and discussion, including this particular video, please do not hesitate to send me a message or an email asking permission, and then just wait for my written consent, and I will definitely give it to you, especially if you will be using this for educational purposes, whether you're a student or a teacher. Okay, so aside from that, in this particular video, I will also be giving you an actual example of a manuscript of a study that has already been completed, so that you will be able to compare the template or the template guide, which I will be presenting, to the actual output, which is an actual research paper that has already been defended. So let us start with the following parts of chapter 5. So chapter 5 is basically divided into 3 parts, and these are the findings, conclusion, and recommendation. But in your manuscript, you should start chapter 5 with what we call the introductory statement. So the introductory statement presents the simplest part of chapter 5, or any chapter for that matter, is the introductory statement. So when we talk about introductory statement, this just simply means that you need to present an introductory statement that informs the reader about the content of the chapter. Ano ang laman ng chapter na ito? Yun lang. You can do this in 1-3 sentences. Again, this is a very simple and direct part of your manuscript for chapter 5. Just present or inform the reader about the content of this particular chapter. Okay, so you may state or write that this chapter will present the following. O sabihin nyo na the summary of findings, the conclusion, and recommendation. If you want to add other than that, just make sure that you do not overdo it. Masyado nang humaba yung discussion. Okay? So, that's the first part. Again, let's mark that. So, that is the introductory statement. The next part of chapter 5, and we will be using the following, is the findings of the study. What are the the findings of the study, or the summary of findings? So this is the second part. The purpose of the following arrows is that for you to be able to trace the basis for every part. So in this case, when we talk about the findings of the findings of the study is based on chapter 4, based on this arrow. Again, when you write the findings of the study, always remember that the content of the findings of the study should be based on chapter 4. Let's start with the first one. The findings should restate, present the specific problems. So you go back to chapter 1 and you just copy-paste in toto the SOP, or specifically the specific problems that you wrote or you printed in chapter 1, the specific problems. So, the specific problems will be your guide in this following part of your manuscript. So, restate the specific problem. For example, SOP number 1. And then immediately at the bottom of SOP number 1 will be the next part, which is the summary of the interpretation coming from chapter 4. Okay, again, after presenting the specific problem number 1, immediately present the summary of the interpretation coming from chapter 4. Chapter 4 contains the result of the statistical analysis if you use the quantitative method. Okay? So if you use a quantitative method, you will implement a statistical formula, statistical analysis, and then you will be presenting tables in chapter 4, and then immediately after the table, it will come with the corresponding interpretation or narrative interpretation of that table. So here, after stating the specific problem or the first specific problem, present the summary of the interpretation coming from chapter 4, which corresponds to the specific problem. So kung ano yung specific problem dito, kunin nyo yung result dito sa chapter 4. Later on, I am going to show you an example of what we are discussing right now. Okay? So, that is the second part of the findings. Okay, now, the second part of number 2 with the corresponding numeric values. So, you have the interpretation. The interpretation should include the numeric values and their verbal description. The numeric values and the verbal description. Both of these are again included in chapter 4. That is why summary of findings of chapter 5 is based or taken from chapter 4, based from the results that were presented in chapter 4. The third part under the findings, use citations and relate the findings. Again, just like the introductory statement, you can use citations here, but do not overdo it. Do not flood this part with citations. The purpose of the citation is to reinforce your finding. Again, the purpose of the citation in this part is to reinforce your finding. So, most probably the citation proper for this particular part are studies. So, use previous studies that you can relate to the result of your finding or to the findings of your study or the result of chapter 4. Okay, so these are the three things that you need to remember when you are writing the findings of the study. Again, I will try to compare this with the actual example that we have later on. So we will just go and finish the other or remaining two parts of this particular chapter. The next part is what we call the conclusion. The conclusion of this particular chapter should be based, referring to the arrow, should be based from the findings of the study. When you form or formulate your conclusions, it should be based on the findings of the study. Okay, what should be the content of your conclusion? Number one, the conclusion is a statement of realization based on the findings of the study. It is a realization. Example of a realization, it's a statement presenting what you believe in based on the findings of your study. So, example of a realization is that blended learning is not that effective in public schools. That's already a statement. Blended learning is not that effective in public schools. That is a statement. That is a conclusion. Now, if that is your conclusion, make sure that you can back that up with evidence. And that evidence or proof or fact should come from the findings of the study. kapag kayo nagsabi ng isang statement dito sa conclusion, kailangan meron kayong ebidensya na manggagaling sa findings of the study. That is what we mean by number one. It is a statement realization based on the findings of the study. Number two, in this part of your manuscript conclusion, this should not include or contain any numeric values coming from the findings of the study. So, if this is presented already in number two under the findings, this should not be repeated in the conclusion anymore. So, this is the common mistakes done or committed in writing the conclusion. A lot of research students still include the numeric values and the interpretation or verbal interpretation of these values in their conclusion. Again, make sure that you do not include them anymore in the conclusion of your study. Okay, again, make sure that all of your conclusion should be based on the findings of the study. The last part is the recommendation of the study. If you can, if you observe, under your screen, you have two arrows coming from the findings and the conclusion of the study, which is the basis of the recommendation. The recommendation should be written based on the conclusion and the findings of the study. So, let us put the numeric marker. So, this is the third part, and the fourth part is the recommendation. So, again, to reiterate and to emphasize, the recommendation should be based on the conclusion and findings of your study. Do not, again, another reminder, do not include any recommendation that is not part of your specific problem, that is not part of the goal of your study, that is not part of the aim of your study. Again, this is another common mistake wherein students include recommendations that are not supposed to be or not aligned in the objective of the study. Okay, make sure that you are aware of that when you write your recommendation. So under recommendation, number one, the recommendation should strictly be based on the findings and conclusion of the study, as reflected by the arrows at the bottom of your screen. Number two, this should contain the specific action that you want the reader to take, that you want the authority or person in charge to take, okay? The one who can take the initiative. So you are talking to that particular person. Make sure that you specify the action that you want them to take that is being recommended. Ano ang gusto mong i-recommend na action na gagawin based from what you have found sa summary of findings and the conclusion of your study? So, it should be clear kung ano yung gusto mong ipagawa. Okay, so that is what we mean by specific action should be, the action should be specific in your recommendation. And the third is, the recommendation should contain the specific focal person. Not only the focal person, but this can also take the form of a department, organization, community, or the like that will initiate the recommended action. So if you have recommended an action, make sure that you also include the focal person, the department, the organization, or the community that would initiate the recommended action. So basically, this is what should be found in your Chapter 5, the Summary of Findings, Conclusion, and Recommendation. So, as mentioned earlier, we will be looking at an actual manuscript wherein we can check if these are reflected on that particular manuscript. So, we are going to go back and forth and try to see and compare if this is observed in that particular manuscript. So, let us go to this part. This is Chapter 5. Summary of findings or the summary conclusion and recommendation. And then as you can see, before the first part, the summary of findings, there are two paragraphs written here. So again, if you recall in our discussion, the introductory statement, which is this part, Okay? Should contain or introduce the content of the chapter. Okay? So, as you can see, if we're going to go through the first sentence, this chapter presents the summary and conclusion derived in the conduct of the study, which is to, again, the restating of the title or the goal or the aim of the study is also included, which is to identify the effect of MATOC inquiry-based strategy in teaching mathematics in grade 7 students. So aside from that, this can already be an introductory statement. So aside from that, he still added information or facts based on the conduct of his study. So with or without the second paragraph, the first paragraph is already enough as part of your introductory statement. And as mentioned earlier, the introductory statement presents the information regarding the content of the chapter. Okay, next, findings of the study. So what can we see under the findings of the study? So as mentioned earlier, the first thing that you need to do is to restate the specific problem. The specific problem here is this one. So it is usually stated with the number of the specific problem and the actual specific problem, which is restated and in bold form. So this is the restated specific problem. So this is also known as the SOP1. Okay, so that is what we mean by restating the SOP. And then immediately below the restated SOP is the result based from chapter 4. So all of these values and discussions are based on chapter 4. So again, as you can see, there are values and there are also verbal interpretations of these values. Okay, there are findings that also use citations. But as we discussed earlier, okay, there is number 3. It is not required that you use citations for every findings of your study. So at least number 1 and number 2, make sure that you observe them. Okay, next. Going back to the example, so these are, again, what we have discussed earlier. This is already SOP number 2. Okay. And the result of SOP number 2, this is SOP number 3. And then the result of SOP number 3, you have numeric values and the verbal interpretation. SOP number 4. And then the result of SOP number 4. And then after that, the conclusion part, okay, so what did we discuss regarding the conclusion? Should be a statement of realization based on the findings of the study, and should not include, let us see if this was observed, should not include or contain any numeric values coming from the findings of the study, which was already presented on the findings of the study. It should not be repeated in the conclusion anymore. Okay, going back, in the conclusion, there are no numeric values that were used. Okay, and then let us see if the statement is a realization or in the form of a stated realization. So number 1, the respondents of the non-math talk has almost the same level. This is a claim. This is a realization. This is a statement. Pareho sila ng level. You cannot say this if you do not have proof, which is presented here, okay, in the summary of findings. That is why you can only make statements, claims like this, if you already have proof, which should be reflected in the summary of findings. Again, the findings reveal that students who have undergone the treatment has higher achievement. Again, this is a claim. And you cannot make this claim, not unless you have proof based on the summary of findings. So all of these are in the forms, are in the form of claims or statement. The resulting implies that both of the group learned. Both groups learned is another claim. Okay, the learning gains is to prove that those students learned in either two studies. Students learned better Students learn better using Math Talk, another claim in conclusion number 4. Okay, now, under recommendation, I think he only has, or the researcher only has 3 recommendations. And then, let us review what we discussed under recommendation. So, this should be strictly based on the findings and conclusion of the study. Okay, number 2, should contain specific action based specific action that is being recommended. So let us try to observe it if there is a specific action in the recommendation that is presented, and it should contain the specific focal person, department, or organization. So let us see if these were observed in the recommendation. Number 1, since the effectiveness of Math Talk has been proven, teachers is already the focal person, should incorporate, and this is already the action, should include Math Talk into their classroom teaching and learning process. Okay, number 2, let us see if there is the action and the focal person are reflected in number 2. Implementation of Math Talk in teaching mathematics should be encouraged. The action. So again, this is the person, this is the action, this is the action, and who should encourage? The administrator's person. Okay? So that we can easily identify the action and the person. Number 3, a similar study must be conducted. Conducted is the action. Conducted to a larger group subject to. So who is going to conduct the study? Researchers. Researchers should conduct a similar study. So again, at least you can already identify what needs to be improved if you are already aware of the elements or components of a recommendation. So this one should include future researchers should, if we are going to include this here, you should write future researchers should conduct, and then you continue a similar study. So you already have the action, and then you have the focal person. Okay, so at least you were able to identify the parts of chapter 5, and you were able to check if these were observed in an actual manuscript. So again, I hope you were able to get something out of this template guide that I developed. So you can easily write chapter 5 when you are already in this particular stage of your research writing. Again, there will be recommended videos that will appear on the side of your screen. And then you will see my logo or my photo on the lower right side. Please click the logo or the photo so that you would be diverted to the screen wherein you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. And don't forget to also share our video to your friends, to your colleagues, to your group mates, and to your relatives so that they can also learn a simplified version of writing this particular part of your research paper. Thank you very much, everyone. Keep learning, stay safe, God bless, and I will see you again in our next video discussion. Maraming salamat po.